Blog Talk Radio.
Hebrew hug music. Righteous too.
The RJB.
Speaking of the
Confederate flag, most importantly, the rebel flag. Why have they Confederate against us? Well, we're going to get to the bottom of this, going to give you the truth and nothing more, nothing less but the truth right here on Rhythm and Poetry. My name is Brother Malachi. I am your host for this edition of Rhythm and Poetry right here on the Blog Talk Radio Network. Well, let's get ready to hear from PZ and Shot again. Hold Weight right here on Rhythm and Poetry. New release right here from Righteous 2.
Hebrew Hood Music.
Every time they see us come, watch them demons shake.
Hey man, here you come with all that stuff, man. Come on, let's go.
Life and death is in your tongue, so watch what you say.
Hey, real talk, what you say yeah. Around here too, man? Real
the
talk.
The name's Hold Weight. If you don't know about Father Ahiah, the name's Hold Weight. And you don't know about his son Yeshua, the name's Hold Weight. Receive the gift of Rawaka Dot, the name's Hold Weight. Forever screaming, crime, Yashura, the name's Hold Weight.
You ain't got to tell me names, Hold Weight. I'm calling a higher. Calling them out, kicking them tables over, just like Yeshua. Digital downloader, the hard copy, man, I'm 2x2. Some of these Hebrews be acting feminine, we call them two wonk fools. I'm laughing at them, same time, we'll put it past them. I ain't trying to be the boy's favorite rapper. They only rap because they Twitter popular. That's the difference between me and them. I'm the son of Jacob, they the son of sin. The rock over, so I'm going in. We don't go ham, but we go shim. I'll cut that bird, put his fur on. Great warrior like Gideon. I tell you the truth, do what you do. I can't judge you like Gideon. I get these bars from my Abba. Rock is my ghost rider, where's Shami Allah? I'm ready for that war, you know I'm a rider. Left hand on my chest, right hand on my Bible, yeah. Every day I'm getting tested, but I don't fall, guess that's progression. Got a whole list of do's and don'ts. Just have a seat, yeah, class and session. Praise the Father, yeah, that's a blessing. You relate to somebody in the same stages. Yeah, I love them when the beat bangs, but you know they hate it when we're true to make it, yeah.
Real talk, what you say around here too, man? Real talk.
His name's Hold Weight. If you don't know about Father Ahiah,
Firstborn children, Christ gotta be alive
for the firstborn children, and they only got their eyes on the firstborn children.
Job 9 and 24, the earth was given into the hand of the wicked. Conquer and divide.
Giving us a false messiah as the Nazian king. causing any harm to nobody. We had no weapons on us at all.
Dorian Johnson says he was walking home from a convenience store with his friend Mike Brown. They were walking on the street when a Ferguson police officer from his vehicle told the boys to get out of the street. Johnson says they kept walking, causing the officer to confront the boys, first from his car, then got out of the car, firing a shot. Johnson says him and Brown were scared and ran away from the officer.
He shot again, and once my friend felt that shot, he turned around and he put his hands in the earth, and he started to get down, but the officer still approached with his weapon drawn, and he fired several more shots.
I woke up thinking in my neck, the Black American complex. Every time I see police, I look up at God and wonder, damn, really, you're my next. You see how hard it is for me. I can't even go to the store or walk in the street without someone making a deal about my complexion. There's just something about my flesh that make you wanna put a bullet in it, armed or unarmed. It really doesn't make a difference. They're going for blood. There ain't no real time for reasoning. No matter how Fox betrayed me on television, doesn't justify my blood in the street and my mother crying. Where can I go when I feel the whole country will want me dead? The ones that's supposed to protect me is aiming for my head. Go to Google, pull up the statistics, tell me how many Black men die in this country every second in my neck.
After telling the officers to leave him alone, they put Garner in a chokehold, pinning him to the ground, where Garner, who was asthmatic, is heard telling the cops he's in trouble. He then becomes unconscious. Soon after, he is dead. This woman says she saw the entire confrontation unfold. He didn't deserve it.
I woke up thinking in my neck, the Black American complex. Let me go and call my mother, tell her I love her, cause after this song I could be a goner. I could've been Oscar Grant, I could've been John Crawford, I could've been Sean Bell, I could've been Eric Garner. Rest in peace to Mike Brown, rest in peace to Trayvon, Ezell Ford, Jordan Davis, the list goes on. What more proof do you need until you finally get it? How many more bodies in the street till you realize America doesn't love you, they treat you less than human? Have more sympathy for a dog before they start shooting, protecting their own while they serving as bullets. I say, can you feel as a man when they're willing to kill children? Protecting their own while they serving as bullets. I say, can you feel as a man when they're willing to kill children in my neck?
I know me. We're playing Walker.
Tasha Thomas of Fairborn says she's been dating 22-year-old John Crawford for several months.
When the police ran over his feet, the boy threw his hands up. He threw his hands up, he shot. And the boy fell. Then he shot him some more. That's what happened.
And it's the music of Vinny D right here on Rhythm and Poetry. You're listening to Rhythm and Poetry, Enemy of the State, final episode. The number to call if you'd like to place a comment or have a question for us, it is 347-205-9279. You press 1 on your phone, and we'll plug you right into our show conversation. Also, the music of our very own Sister Fire Harris featuring PZ, Who You Gonna Run To, and Firstborn Young King named David. And we started it off with PZ and Shot, Whole Weight, from the new release, Righteous 2. You can get that Righteous 2 right there at shodjudah.bandcamp.com or just go to realjudah.com. Available on iTunes right there. Check it out. Righteous 2 is now released. So hopefully we'll be able to hear from Shod Judah. We'll have an interview coming up very soon, very soon. So stay tuned. We'll have that out for you, the information for you within the weeks to come. Well, let's get to it. How did this get started with the Enemy of the State? Well, you all know that we're broadcasting from Hattiesburg, Mississippi, as well as Dallas, Texas, and our office located in New Orleans, Louisiana. Well, in the state of Mississippi, you all know that we're last in everything. So how did this get started? Well, this episode got started 3 weeks ago from the question on, will our state flag be changed? Pros and cons on it. Well, we know the cons about it, but we want to get to the root of the cons. What are they so against us not changing the flag to represent all the people of the state of Mississippi, as well as the rebel flag? Why is it that so many diehard people from the South as well as in the North feel so proud about the Confederate battle flag? Well, you all know what happened in Charleston, South Carolina. I've got something very interesting for you, because if you don't have the knowledge of a thing, you will not have ammunition to fight against anything. Here's my answer on knowledge. Knowledge is power. It unlocks the key to the unknown. And get this, you all know my story. I asked the Most High, why do they hate us so much? Why? Why do they hate us so much? What is the issue with this black and white thing here in America, as well as all over the Western Hemisphere, as well as the entire planet? You all know that they fed us a lie, that they said that all blacks came from Ham. That is not true. The enemy of the Negroes here in America, black people from Ham were the Egyptians. That's right. We were enslaved by the Egyptians and led from Egyptian captivity out of Egypt back into the promised land through Moses. You know, Moses was the deliverer of the people of the nation of Israel. Did you know, and we're going to talk about that a little later, did you know that Israel, the people of Israel, not the land, get this, the people, the nation of Israel, are a group of people, not the land. And you all know the people over there in Israel today are not actually the bloodline of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. They are not. The true Jews, so to speak, the true Israelites, are the lead tribe of Judah here in America, the tribe of Judah. And momentarily, I'm going to play Castanario, who will give you the lineup of the 12 tribes of Israel. But our lesson today is the enemy of the state, the final episode of what started all this at the university levels of removing the state flag, which encompassed the emblem of the Confederate rebel battle flag that is inside the state of Mississippi's state flag. Not only is it removed from all three major universities here in Mississippi, but all HBCUs here in the state of Mississippi, as well as most metropolitan, most populated black municipalities here in the state of Mississippi, such as the city that I live in, Hattiesburg, Mississippi, whose city limits are predominantly black. Now, the University of Southern Mississippi, which is inside of Hattiesburg, Mississippi, with a student population of over 20,000, here's what they did and why they removed the Mississippi state flag. The Student Government Association at the University of Southern Mississippi will vote November the 5th on a resolution to officially remove the state flag from both the Hattiesburg and Gulf Coast campuses. Senior politician, science major, and SGA Senator Nathan Barrow, author RO5F15, a resolution to remove the Mississippi state flag from the university grounds on the basis that the flag does not represent the values of the student body or of the university and is inconsistent with the Southern Miss student creed, according to the resolution. This is organic, Barron told the student prince. This is from the ground up, and that is what we want in Senate, for the students to get involved now that we know that the flag has been down. It has become exciting news, according to SGA Vice President Kyle Stoner. Students continue to send their opinions to senators via direct email and the Speak Up Southern Miss application on the SGA website. Their input, Stoner said, is of great value to the Senate. As the elected voice of the student body, the Student Government Association Senate is responsible for representing the diverse voices of the student body of the University of Southern Mississippi through democratic process, Stoner said. This resolution was created by a senator in order to allow for the student's voice to be heard on the current event of the state flag of Mississippi. The vote comes just over a week after the October 28th removal of the state flag from the front of the Hattiesburg campus. That Wednesday, students and faculty protested both against and for flying the Mississippi state flag on campus. The Confederate battle flag represents violence, oppression, and hate to many Mississippians and to people all over the world, said Susan Harakisi, associate professor of social works and organizer of the flag protest. Such a symbol does not reflect the best Mississippi has to offer. It is an offensive to many as the swastika. Counter-protests like junior psychologist major Christine Miller disagree. To take it down feels like you're rejecting everything you are and how far you've come, as if you're splitting on all the progress you've made, Miller said in a story by the student prince. The SGA Senate resolution says, furthermore, the University of Southern Mississippi shall not raise the flag of the state of Mississippi on the Hattiesburg or Gulf Coast campus as long as the Confederate emblem in whole or in part remains on the flag. The student prince will report the SGA Senate vote later Thursday. Stay with the student prince as the story develops. And you can keep up with that story online by going to Student Prince, that's StudentPrintz.com. That is the campus newspaper for the University of Southern Mississippi of both campuses here in Hattiesburg as well as in Gulfport, Mississippi. So that is what's happening at one particular school here in the state of Mississippi. Now, we've had two other schools here, the University of Mississippi, better known as Ole Miss. They voted and removed the flag from its campus, as well as earlier this year, Mississippi State did. And on, like I said, on a lot of the major predominantly black cities here in the state of Mississippi, the state flag is no longer flying over the city's municipality buildings in many of the cities here in Mississippi. So why has our governor rejected the acknowledgement of removing the state flag or even attempt to try to listen to the people? Well, I'm not going to quote what he said, but all I can tell you is this. This is an election year. Now that the election is over and he won re-election, let's see if he rethinks his position according to the uproar that's going on. Even the representatives and senators in our nation's capital who represent the state of Mississippi, like I said last week, I was floored when Representative Whitaker said that it's time now for the state of Mississippi to change its state flag. I was floored when I heard that. But you all know there's a deeper root that goes deeper than just a flag. It deals with racism. It deals with a group of people that want to oppress another group of people. And when we come back, we're going to read to you Psalms 83 and let you read how they have come up against. This is why you need to know who you are. You're not a Gentile. You belong to the 12 tribes of Israel. And for you Negroes here in America, you are from the tribe of Judah. Here's Castanario right here on Rhythm and Poetry. Let's blow the shofar.
Shema Yasha Allah Ahaya Allah Haya Nawa Ahaya Akha.
La musica de Harry Fry.
We all lost tribes. Scattered little sheep, taught false history, worship the image of the beast. Celebrities got bread, but their souls ain't free. Got bodyguards, but the truth will set you free. Money only divides, poverty is unity. We on welfare lines, and our stories is kinda deep. Catch me from the HRA, right to GOC. They lied to us for decades, the truth will set you free. No RFRDs, I am not a number. I am not a barcode, I don't sleep in a slumber. Famines in the summer, our youth is getting slimmer. Pray a flight is not in the Sabbath nor the winter. Benina and the Penta when the terrorists came through. Slave troops to Gad, America said to this was Azarus. Chosen ones was here, Axe Edgerus. The Queen believed Columbus cause he read it in the past. Real roll call, flow to Shafar. Calling all tribes, this is Israel. Roll call, flow to Shafar. Calling all tribes, this is Israel. Roll call, flow to Shafar. Calling all tribes, this is Israel. Roll call, flow to Shafar. Calling all tribes. I know that poverty works in tribulation. I know that poverty works in tribulation. Ayo, back to the scripts. Hosea 4 and 6, same ones on the strip rolling 456. If they knew who they was, rather who they is, they would stop shedding blood. And stick to the scripts. Tribe Nephtali, Filipinos in Hawaii, the Samoans, Pacific Islanders, crown of my Boricuas, stay from the tribe of Ephraim, Dominicans, Caloquia, tribe of Simeon, West Indians from Benjamin, Aborigines, Somali Indians, their nativity tribe is Reuben, South Americans, Asher, Mexicans, Issachar, Cuban, Manasseh, Cigar Capital, Central American tribe is Zebulon, Guatemala to Panama, Most High got a plan for ya, Haitians is Levi, the chief priest, Kingdom come, y'all gon' be so fresh and so clean. No Andre 3G, but Andre 3G, tribe Judah, your Negroes like Christ the King. No Andre 3G, but Andre 3G, tribe Judah, your Negroes like Christ the King. Israel, roll call, blow the shofar, calling all tribes, this is Israel, roll call, blow the shofar, calling all tribes, this is Israel, roll call, blow the shofar, calling all tribes. Calling all tribes, this is Israel, roll call, blow the shofar. Calling all tribes, calling all tribes.
Don't shoot, I can't breathe, I can't breathe.
right here on Riddle Man Poetry. The American Dream. What is the American Dream? Apparently, the Negroes here in America are not a part of it. Welcome back to Riddle Man Poetry right here on the Blog Talk Radio Network, where we just about got a little over an hour left right here on the live show. Just want to remind you, you can always share our show when we get through with it. You can always share our show on your Facebook page as well as your Twitter page or any social media network that you have right here from our website at blogtalkradio.com/menempower. Want to send some shout-outs right now, saying a shalom hello to everyone in the greater Atlanta area, saying a shalom hello to everyone out there, our regular listeners in Douglas, Georgia. Also, a shalom and hello to everyone in the greater Tallahassee area on the campus of Florida State University, as well as Florida A&M. Shout-outs to everybody in the DFW. As you know, Sister Harris has the week off, so she'll be back with us next Saturday on our show. So looking forward to her getting some rest up, as well as I need some rest. But it's all good right here. I enjoy what I do. Well, let's get into it. Well, let's go to Psalms 83. And before that, I want to give you some credits of our music. Shalom to all of our artists that have contributed to our show, such as Stevie K, the music of Black Lives Matter, as well as Ashley Carr, Children of the Slave. And we started it out with Castanario, Cass D, or Kazar, Blow the Shofar. Psalms 83, you won't believe this, because if you believe that you are a Gentile, you have not a clue of what this is all about that I'm getting ready to read. Psalms 83, a psalm of Asaph. Keep not thy silence, O God. Hold not thy peace, and be not still, O God. For lo, thy enemies made a tumult, and they that hate thee have lifted up the head. Verse 3, they have taken crafty counsel against thy people. Who are thy people? Who are thy people? Now, we just played a song recently, Blow the Shofar, calling all the roll call for the 12 tribes of Israel. And you know that one of the tribes of Israel, the lead tribe, is the tribe of Judah, the Negroes here in America, North America, U.S. and Canada. That's right. That is that particular tribe, thy people, the Native American Indians, the Native American Indians. Who are the people south of the border? We call them Mexicans, but they are the tribe of Issachar. You've got the tribe of Gad, the Native American Indians, as well as the tribe of Issachar here in this land known as a.k.a. Babylon the Great or Sodom and Egypt. That's right. America, the United States of America, is that land of our captivity. Moving on, verse 3 again. They have taken crafty counsel against thy people and consulted against thy hidden ones. Verse 4, they have said, come, let us cut them off from being a nation. Who would have thought that we were a nation? Who would have thought? Because of the sins of our father, the Most High scattered us. The Most High scattered us, and these are the results of our captivity, of the disobedience that we have. Now he's waking us up. They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance. For they have consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee. Duh. Look at this. They had it back then. They still got it going on now. They have confederate against thee. The Confederate States of America. They have confederate against thee. And if you don't believe that, look at what happened in the Civil War. This Confederate emblem, which represents the Confederate States of America, so why would these people want to remember that era in history? It belongs in a museum. That state flag, as well as the Confederate flag, belongs in a museum, just as the rebel flag that was flying over the state capitol in South Carolina when I lived in Columbia, South Carolina, which as they retired that flag this year and is now in a museum. The state flag of Mississippi now belongs in a museum. You heard me. It belongs in a museum. Well, it's heritage, not hate. Yes, your heritage is hate. That's what your heritage means. This is what they were promoting back then. Hate. Hate. If you didn't know slavery, slavery was all about hating a people of because their skin color. And if you want to get deeper, it was because they were the children of Israel. We found that out in Deuteronomy chapter 28, verses 68. Bondsmen and bondswomen. That's slavery. That's right. We are the people. This is the reason why they hate you so much. It's because you are the chosen one. When you find out who Esau and Jacob are, then you'll know the truth. Esau, and don't take this personally now, Esau is the white race and Jacob is the black race, the other blacks. People say that we all came from Ham. No. Black people here in America from the tribe of Judah and all the 12 tribes of Israel came from Shem. Look at the bloodline. And if you didn't know, the white race, our brother, our so-called uncle, so to speak, Esau, they came from Isaac. That's right. They came from Abraham and Isaac. They are not part of Jacob. We are from Jacob. They are Esau. Esau and Jacob were two brothers born of Isaac and their mother. We got the same mother, just different pigmentation. Their blood is showing through their skin. That's why they coined the phrase, don't take this personally. That's why they coined the phrase rednecks, the blood showing through skin. All the people of color had no issues with other people of color. But when Esau came on the scene, he was the one that was totally different. That's the way it was. That's the way it is. And the people of color all over the world are the majority. Now, I didn't mean to get on my soapbox here, but let me move on in this scripture, because without the scripture, I can't prove anything. Without historical facts, I can prove half of the things. But a lot of people don't want to believe this Bible, but this Bible here is a history book and a history book of people. It is not a religious book. It is a book of history and laws. Ooh, I'm sounding so good. Let me pat myself on the back. All right. Verse 5. For they have consulted together with one consent. They are confederate against thee. The tabernacles of Edom and the Ishmaelites. Ah, you know who the Ishmaelites are, don't you? They have a name that they go by, the Arabs. Uh-huh, you guessed it. Not necessarily they are Muslim. That is a religion. But that is their nationality, the Arab leagues or the Arab nations. The tabernacle of Edom, we know who Edom is, the Esau, Edom, the nation of Edom, and the Ishmaelites of Moab, and the Hagarites, Gebel, and Ammon, and Amalek, and the Philistines with the inhabitants of Tyre. Ashur also is joined with them. They have hopped the children of Lot. Do unto them as unto the Midianites, as to Sisera, as Jabin at the brook of Kesar. Now, this right here, that is a key. That is history right there. That is information that our fathers put down in our records, our history book, not a religious book. If you're in church and they say stay away from the Old Testament, you need to get out of that church. They're keeping you confused and keeping you in bondage. And I'm going to say this. If you're having church on Sunday, this is one of the laws in the book that said you're not supposed to do. The Most High did not create Sunday to be a day of rest or a day of worship to remember him. He did that for Saturday. Why do you think all the denominations are so divided? They major on this. This one majoring on that. This one majoring on that. And who is the author of confusion? Ah, the light has come on now. That's right. You guessed it. Satan, Lucifer, a.k.a., you know who he is, the one from the pit of hell. That's right. Lucifer, that fallen angel, created all this mess that's going on. Hosea 4 says, I go back to it all the time. My people, who people? My people. Who is the people that he's talking about? He's talking about the children of Israel. And if you do not know the children of Israel or who they are, well, looks like you're just lost. But now it's time to wake up. Time to wake up and find the truth. Because at the end of the book, in the book of Revelation, it talks about the 12 tribes that were sealed, the 144,000. Why is it important to know that? Because he has come and only coming back for the house of Israel. They're the first, like my brother Young King named David, we the firstborn. We're the firstborn children. That's right. Oh, I can go on and on and on. This is why this information is so important. Waking our people up. But, unfortunately, there is a prophecy that out there that not all of Israel is going to wake up. They're going to stay in bondage. I just so happen not to be one that is in the bondage of not knowing who we are. Thank the Most High for the ones that are listening to this broadcast. Know who they are. And even if you are a Gentile, there's a scripture that says, I will bless Israel so I can be blessed. Now, I see programs on TV, ministries that are redirecting the truth to the people over there in Israel today who are not the bloodline of Israel. They're always asking for money. Won't you please help these God's people? Won't you please help God's people? Won't you please help God's people? These are the people here in America telling you to send money so we can get these fake Jews who practice Judaism over there so they can go there. They want a blessing by blessing the children of Israel. But they don't realize that the blessing is blessing the Negroes, the Latinos here in America, as well as the tribe of Gad are your true Jews. That's right. Those are your true Jews or the true tribe of Israel. Because Jew is a synonymous to relates back to the tribe of Judah. The whole nation is the house of Israel. Judah is the southern tribe. The northern tribe represents the tribe of Gad and Issachar. All right, and that is another subject for another time. So I hope I've given you a lot of information on this. We're now into our second hour, and let's go back to the music now, and when we come back, we will find out and get into the utter captivity that Israel was in. You're listening to Rhythm and Poetry, brought to you by the Men Empowered Organization, right here on the Blog Talk Radio Network at blogtalkradio.com.
Every day, my brother struggled just to
wake up.
Avoid the pain, take a substance just to stay afloat. Cause socially, economically, you find us on the bottom. They make the truth.
Let you know about it. It's so hard to make a living. You can't get a job. How you gonna stay grounded? Police all around you. The streets all around you. We on the news every channel. You kill our own people. Burning out like candles. These rappers wanna talk about money. Black people still on the streets homeless. Black people wanna talk about money. Black people can't afford a new toilet. Walk around head high like we flawless. You gotta be crazy. We in a dangerous species. We murder our own babies. We lack knowledge, miseducated, no patience. Did you ever take a look in the Bible and see that we used to be greatness? We had a nation, outnumbering the stars. We abandoned our God. Take a look how we changed it. Slaves coming off of a slave ship. They used to put chains on the wrists. Now you put the chains on our necks. We're still slaves like we don't exist. We're still slaves like we don't exist. You better wake up quick before it's too late. Deuteronomy chapter 28, look at it.
They don't know, the untold story of a black man.
They don't know,
man, it's so hard to be a black man.
We fight to stay alive, from day to day we justify.
This is the story of a black man.
Started at the top, now we here. Here, at the bottom.
Oh, great King, where have you gone? Do you remember? Is your legacy gone? Away. You were the first man with language.
Yeah.
First to write and speak.
Yeah.
First to form a system.
Spiritual
belief.
So these people of the Bible was once prince and princesses, kings and queens.
Now get up off your knees. This is the story of a black man.
They don't know.
The untold story of a black man.
They don't know.
Man, it's so hard to be a black man. We fight to stay alive. This is the story of a black man.
They don't know.
Of what they think, but they really have no understanding of how we feel as a people. Suppose the Bible had that answer. Suppose the Bible had that answer. Now think about it.
Put the lamb's blood on the doorpost, and the angel of death passed on. Then they turned around and took our Savior on the same day. We've been going tit to tat for a long, long time. All they did was help us defeat death. Yasha said, don't think that you're taking my life. No, no.
Yes. Jesus.
I'm laying it
hope.
Down.
Hope. Uh-huh. Hope. And on this day, I am speechless. I'ma go hard for the same side and keep it. Been a long moon, praise the higher that we reached it. Though the wine is yeastless, I can taste the sweetness. So many Hebrews, the 12 tribes, feel so good when I'm in the midst of my peace. I ain't never knew a love like this. We are prayed up by the ancient hands of the righteous. Abraham, Moses, Jacob, Isaac, never no violence. Just a bunch of Christ kids told us we was nobody, but we come from greatness. Wake up, your history don't start on no slave ship. Where were you before then? What language did you speak? African American? That's too many countries. These commandments is law, statutes and these laws. What's a holiday? We do holy days, I'll serve them all. Let's get this asshole.
Who's that? That lamb on fire, sweet aroma in the air. Father, bless your children, your holy nation, your Israel. All hail our Messiah, a little wine, unleavened bread. One time for Yeshua, for he hung and he bled.
For the world, for the world, for the world.
For he hung and he bled.
For the world, for the world, for the world, for the world.
Sweet aroma in the air.
Father, bless your children, your holy nation, your Israel. All hail our Messiah, a little wine, a living bread. One time for Yeshua, for he hung and he bled.
For the world, for the world, for the world.
I know if I take care of you, you're gonna take care of me. That's what I'm talking about.
I love you, I'm not afraid to show it in public. If your love was a mixtape, the whole world would wanna dub it. You got light in you. You're not afraid to sacrifice for me, so I'm not afraid to sacrifice for you. No matter what I do, you got my back. As a matter of fact, I can't make it without you. You reverse what's for man, you take care of your man. Moving out and about, I'm proud to hold your hand. You're a gift from heaven, I'm having so many good times. Your name should be Florida Evans. You're full of so many blessings, cause you're godly. I pray to y'all that you won't depart me. I'ma love you even if it hurts. I lay my life down and put your needs first. First, and that's for life. I know if I take care of you, you gon' take care of me, and that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. I know if I take care of you, you gon' take care of me, and that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. I'ma love you like Messiah loved them Hebrews, and lay my life down just like he do. Us break up, look at what we've been through. Knew you were meant for me the moment I seen you, baby. I'ma treat you like a lady till you're well past 80 and halfway crazy. I ain't happy unless I'm pleasing you. I wanna see what y'all sees in you. You're part of the reason why he's blessing me and you. I couldn't imagine me leaving you or cheating on you. I'm cleaving to you like Messiah said for me to do. Cause I ain't seen in no one what I'm seeing in you. So I'ma handle you with care. When tribulations come, we gon' handle them with prayer. Yeah, and that's for life. I know if I take care of you, you gon' take care of me. And that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about.
It's the one right here. You know it. Yeah. Get him that truth. History. Not this. You know I'm going with this one. You feel me? Check it. My The history they gave to me was fallacy and slavery. Nothing of our royalty and bravery. They had to be playing me. Something every February month of our peasantry. They out to embarrass me, but shackles are running free. Underground rebel, they're getting beat. Rather be with Nat Turner, like in the streets. We the people, the constitution just waiting, you see. I'm talking deep within the sea. It's always something you bleed. Go ahead and dig in some of your roots, call your family tree. See, like they thought of one of them chips, and that's so hard to believe. You see, they hid it in the book, so I decided to read. Breaking down the puzzle, building on every piece. Jerusalem, the motherland, after we cross the Red Sea. Timbuktu, I go to city, really kings and queens. They remind you annually about your state of being. Captivity's imprisoning, that's why we fill up the bin. Divide and conquer, it got you breaking nations. So my brother, if you a king, go ahead and take your place and solidify your castle, really trying to take us. UEP, Malcolm X, and MLK. Yeah, they all be killers, man. I don't know if y'all paying attention. It's a black genocide out here, I'm trying to hit story. I'm here to tell you my story.
The past already passed, the history repeats itself. Power is in the knowledge, so I'ma teach myself. Keep the lies beneath me, real office for each himself. Real eyes, realize, so they can see for self. His story by me, the blind to defeat himself. How first of a seal, brother, the best of left. A million make a march, but if we ain't taking the right steps, eugenics will end us, and there'll be none of us left. We need to jump to the front like Rosa, one to the test like Malcolm. Where the truth is a vest, knowledge my helmet, and use my words as a check. Aim at the history text, blot out the nonsense that they teach in the next generation. I won't let them enslave them. The truth will set you free, but it's lost in the brain, man. Been a drought for this world, and they've been praying for rain, man. Won't I control the clouds, so this is all in his game plan.
We got people to rise from about this situation, man. Go watch the Mind for 21 documentary. Get yourself out these ghettos, out these prisons. Come on, kings and queens, let's rise. We greater than what we're given, man. Forget the shortest month out the year. Got a lifetime worth of black history. Live it live.
My shine. history. That's what we're talking about. All right, the music of For Life by King Dawee. Before that, we had the music of Brother Maverick Bronze, For the World. And we started out with Fernando and Shyad Music, The Story of a Black Man. You're listening to Rhythm and Poetry right here on the Blog Talk Radio Network. Just got under an hour left, maybe pretty close to about maybe 35 minutes left right here on the live show. If you'd like to make a comment or if you have a question, the number to call is 347-205-9279. You press 1 on your phone and we'll plug you right into our show conversation. Just to let you know, the chat room is always open when we're here live on Saturday night. Don't forget, you can always contact us when we're off the air at area code 504-484-98. And you can always check us out on our Twitter page, that's menempowered at twitter.com, and email us at menempoweredtoprosper@yahoo.com. And don't forget, you can like us on Facebook. That's Rhythm and Poetry Music page right there on Facebook. Just letting you know again, Sister Harris will be back with us on next Saturday right here on Rhythm and Poetry. How many of you all know that not only were we enslaved the first time in Egypt and a second time in symbolic Egypt, which is here in the Western Hemisphere, the Americas, but we were enslaved another five times. Let me break it down for you. All right, the Egyptian slavery, number one, you all know about that, got delivered. Moses was the deliverer out of there. Slavery under the Assyrians, that can be found in 2 Kings Verse 17 and 6, chapter 1, 77, excuse me, 7 and 1, I mean, excuse me, chapter 17, 1 through 14, and 2 Kings chapter 17 and 6, slavery under the Ethiopian or Cushite Babylonian Empire, 1 Chronicles 9 and 1. Slavery under the Persians. That is in Ezra chapter 9, verse 9. Slavery under the Greeks. That can be found in your Apocrypha book. And let me, for all you new people here, there were 14 books deleted out of your King James Bible. It's the 1611 edition of the King James Bible. That was by the Greeks. You can find that information under 1 Maccabees 8 and 18. Then came the Roman captivity. The Romans. And this is what Christ said when 70 AD came around. Luke chapter 21, verse 24. And don't forget the Ishmaelites were the Islamic slavery. They started it first before the Edomites came and got us off the west coast of Africa. Well, who would have thought all this slavery? And by the way, I want you all to take this down. On YouTube, one of the best videos that I send to anybody who is just now getting into the truth or someone you were talking to, needing more details, I send them a video of this brother by Drawback Jacob. And the video that I send people out is, now there's plenty of them out there, but this particular one, it gives you the history before slavery. It gives you biblical and historical information and what is about to happen. All that can be found on Drawback Jacob's video, and it is the conspiracy, the biblical history and conspiracy of blacks in the Bible. you get that video and you send that out to people that you're talking to, oh, you can wake up some folks. What you will do, now don't get wavery on this. When you send it out, you're just planting a seed. You just got to let that seed grow. How can they refuse the information if they are a student of the Bible and a student of history? Because this Bible here is history. We can always refer and go back to Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. Who are the only people in the world that went into slavery by way of ships, in the belly of cargo slave ships? Who are those people? Thou shalt see it no more again, and there you shall be sold unto your enemies. That means America is our enemy. This land is our enemy. So, this nation is not one nation under God, not the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. No, 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 no. Because our fathers never knew this place full of idolatry, full of sin, full of disobedient people, full of murderers, full of hateful people. That is our enemy. Verse 64 says, and the Lord shall scatter thee among all people from one end of the earth even unto the other, and there thou shalt serve other gods, not the Most High. Because when we were in captivity, we were serving these Canaanite gods here in America. Now that we're awoken, we serve the Most High. Whether neither thou nor thy fathers have known, even wood and stone. Stone, speaking of Islam, that stone that they worship in Mecca, the wood, the Christianity, all the idolatry in this land. That's right. These are your enemies. Remember, I told you that the Islamic people enslaved us before the Edomites did here in the Western Hemisphere. That's right. Verse 62, and ye shall be left few in number, whereas ye were as the stars of heaven for multitude, because thou wouldst not obey the voice of the Lord thy God. This is the reason why. The reason why we're in the state that we're in these days. All right. Well, with just a few minutes left, we've got under 30 minutes left. The number to call is 347-205-9279 if you have a comment or if you have a question pertaining to the topic that we are talking about. Not just trying to get on here talking about an advertisement, you want to do this and do that. We're talking about the topic, the enemies. We are the enemy of the state. That is what we're talking about. If you have anything pertaining to the truth, then we want to hear from you. You're listening to Rhythm and Poetry right here on the Blog Talk Radio Network at blogtalkradio.com. Here's Hen featuring Uriah.
I know who you are. Yeah, I say I know who you are. Yeah, yeah, come on. We stiff neck, we wild, we on the corner, wildin' out. We ignorant, we proud, rebellious.
I know who you are, boy, you need some help. Open your mind and free yourself. Truth and knowledge overpowers wealth. Put education on the shelf and take a second look and see what y'all you took. Fall in love with a bunch of crooks and forget you the children of that book. To the enemies they told you, made you believe anything they told you, and left you with two decisions. You could choose death or choose religion, but you fell off Jacob's ladder and chose to listen to the master. Got caught in the devil's rapture, now your life is a whole disaster.
Yeah, I said I know who you are. I know who you are. And I know where you're going.
can't see it. Got a truth, but don't believe it. Curse of being disobedient. Yeah. Today's enslaved in Egypt. Then Moses said, let my people go. Then we act like we ain't know who was our father. We didn't even bother to listen. And not to mention, we blatantly worship others. We went from one to another. We threw stones at our brothers. When they was trying to just bring us back to the truth, there's nothing wrong with that. Like Stephanos in the book of Acts. All he did was take it back.
Yeah, I said,
I know who you are.
I know who you are.
And I know where you're going.
We stiff neck. We wild. We on the corner. Wildin' out, we ignorant, we proud, we belly us.
I know the keepers of the law. We're standing tall, staying righteous above them all. What's the call, coach? The other teams fit with many men that's small. So cause they don't know the identity, but I do, so they envy me. Cause you're a nation of people that's so rebellious. Accusers of your brother, when he speaks the truth, you get jealous. But I stay one accord with all my righteous fellas. Cause we know who we are, there's nothing else that you can tell us.
Nothing. Yeah, I said,
I know who you are.
I know who you are.
And I know where you're going.
Yeah, I said,
I know who you are.
I know who you are.
And I know where you're going.
Wildin' out, we ignorant, we proud, rebellious, I strive to be like them, we try, our own culture we deny, so unaware, we blind, we searching for a sign, I know who you are. 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 Who you are. I know who you are.
This is Nana. You're in tune to Rare Jewels with Clarity and Jens on the beat. Keep it locked.
This is how the UK do it. Rare Jewels Project. Come on. Come on. Come on.
In the street. After watching the pain, couldn't believe what I'd seen. A soul tortured by flames, obviously. She made screams, each cut in my lobe. She said, somebody help me to find hope. Yo, so I approached. Asked her if she needed my coat, cause it was raining. And life had a shivering cold. Said, here's a fact, if you smoke, I see you looking a hero with me. I find it in the mirror when I look real close. She turned to me. I tell stories and songs. She said, well, if you look and find that your reflection is gone. Must admit it had me shook, feeling pain that strong. Cause when she spoke, it's like compassion was a slave to her tongue. I said, talk to me, tell me where it all stems from. She said, walk with me, where do I start? She wished her heart would stop beating like that of her son's. And she had drunk herself sober, wishing sanity come. She said she held him as his last breath left from his lungs, but didn't know he was involved in the road and the gun. She blamed herself for not keeping him away from the slums, and wished his father would to help, but he was always a bum. She knows now why he's old, he was tired of crumbs. Wish she could have gave him everything that he'd ever won. What could I say? My heart bled with every funk. She said, if I was on the roof now, I surely would jump. She said his name, I dare not say it again. I saw the pain, life had written it on her face. She said, the day took my sunshine away. The night sky came and ever since then it stayed. Memories leave a stain, faces try to be brave. I can't even touch his room, it's still exactly the same. I fade and I fade as each hour passes, it plays and it plays. Yo, the scene just won't leave me alone. I held my breath, had to think about my words when I spoke. I said, do you feel his soul when you feel the wind blow? She replied, I see him in my dreams at night. He and I fly, then I awake to reality's light. Watching her speak, I realize to die to the beat for nine. It's coming like sense, those the sound of a mother crying. Streets is cold, I heat him spitting fiery rhymes. Giving sight to the blind, as vivid as every line. I read the signs, that life grows up. These are the times of no love, praying for the dough. Cause the road is full of donuts. Niggas from prison smoking roll-ups. Didn't learn their lesson back in jail before they can get their pro cut. Maybe we dumb, maybe we stupid. This love for the money surely ain't the work of Cupid. You just trying to clock the Rubik's Cube alive. Some are trying from ruthless, others still strive, though it seems useless. So after talking to my mystery lady, I guess the thinking, will it change or forever stay crazy? So as I walk through the valley of the shadow of me, peace be with you all. Cash is signing off, down to stay with them. Listen, please, Lord, forgive them for they sinning, cause they know not what was written, how we're living. I believe that there will be a change to speak through me. I'm with you all the way. Stay with them. Listen, please, Lord, forgive them for they sinning, cause they know not what was written, how we're living. I believe that there will be a change to speak through me. I'm with you all the way.
Yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I stay composed, no fear complex. Though amongst gritty streets, lost souls and petty beef, I ready heat from my pen on a blank sheet. My rap speed is a track meet, taking batons from the crippled and weak that's overworked to eat. They struggling on the grind to find time to sleep, or find it hard to dream or spend their money in peace. My premonition, spit like crush competition. My origins originate from them dark quarters, so I spew fresh water for the dark horses. The race for the faithful, not the swift portion, but to the ones that be looking out for the orphans. These fatherless times and sons bucking with nines before they got hair of puberty's even defined. So my definition of a real MC is Christ in tan skin, resembling me. The reflection of reality, hope is living in clarity. I'm with him, Lord. Be with us, Lord. I'm with him, Lord. Cause you with them, Lord. The anguish of villains for hatred and children, and chain them as killers till their nature is cold as the winter is chilling. It's gristling with pillars, suffocating their lungs and their feelings. Mothers will miss them, puppets in prison, cussing and dealing. Destructive resilience, knuckles and niggas punching their figures and figures. They swallowing liquors and porn for kindred. Ignored by the system, so bored in the school that they heartily listen. It's hard to dismiss it as this young as lack of attention. Something is missing, depicting puzzling pictures. We fumble with sickness and only use all the medicine for the symptoms. The pedestals for the pimp. Wow. Perpetual hellish position. I speculate when I spit this, will they ever take entry?
Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, walking. I stay composed, cause you got my steps. Regardless of what I face, none of it is a threat. For worse or better, all of my trials are for test. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I stay composed, cause you got my steps. Regardless of what I face, none of it is a threat. For worse or better, all of my trials are for test. Stay with them. Listen, please, Lord, forgive them for they sinning, cause they know not what was written, how we're living. I believe that there will be a change to speak through me. I'm with you all the way. Stay with them. Listen, please, Lord, forgive them for they sinning, cause they know not what was written, how we're living. I believe that there will be a change to speak through me. I'm with you all the way. Wait.
When I say Hebrews, I mean myself, friend, cause I can't redeem myself. 3.
We make it through the ages. When the judge throw the book, we just read through the pages. Get the maximum of pounds, but the minimum of wages. They beat us on the ships, Then they whipped us when they slaved us. Psalms 82, we gods, how they break us. They say we can't do anything if you put your head to it. But they ain't say what would happen if you put your head through it. We throw up gang signs and put down lane rhymes. They put my time in the cup just to waste mine. We drowning in water, that's only waistline. If we just stand up, we won't drown. I'm bringing you truth, but the truth weigh pounds. And they spiritually weak, they can't get it off the ground. They nicknamed us Negroes, but we super Hebrew heroes. I'm just trying to wake my people, yeah.
We've been trotted down all of our life, and our eyes closed, so we can't see the light. And they call us criminals, and they treat us like some animals. They call us Negroes, but disguise who we are. Deuteronomy 28:68 explains it all. And they call us criminals, then we must be thieves, cause we still here.
We buy shoes more than we find clues. Did y'all know Michael Jordan fund private jails? And guess who they put in them private cells? Negroes. It's true that the world out to get us. We abandoned our protector, now we unprotected. It will be the end of the world today. A black man is elected. Radars was built for us, don't think you going undetected. We've been disrespected, neglected, and rejected. And that's just by our own people. This is the end, but we in last day too. Got a long road, but you won't make it halfway through. Government shut down, just the mass they use. Confusing all the masses on the cash they abuse. When they can just print more, I just pray you know what you in for.
Please stop. We can try to down all of our life, and our eyes closed, so we can't see the light. And they call us criminals, and they treat us like some animals. They call us Negroes to disguise who we are. Deuteronomy 28:68 explains it all. And they call us criminals, then we must be thieves, cause we're still here.
Here on Rhythm and Poetry Negroes, and before that we had the music of Rare Jewels and Clarity right here with you all the way. Throwback music right there, as well as Hen featuring Uriah, I Know Who You Are. Well, I wanted to cut it short because our time is just about out, and this is our final episode of The Enemy of the State, and I believe you've got plenty of information. You can always go back to our previous shows that we've had on this topic, Rhythm and Poetry, Enemy of the State, Part 1 and 2, and now the final episode is tonight. I want to let you all know what is getting ready to happen to the people who don't believe, the people who fight against the Israelites, the true Israelites. This is what's getting ready to happen, and it can be found in the book of Obadiah in your King James Bible. It's only one chapter. I'm going to read as much as possible, and if you not have your Bibles open, you can always get it, check it out later on that. And for those of you all who do not believe in the Most High, or do not believe in the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, I hope you find him soon, because time is winding down. I know you've all probably heard that before in churches and somewhere all over television, you know, and that sort of thing like that, and you say, ha ha, it don't seem like it. They've been saying that for years. Well, the same thing they said about Noah, about it's going to be a flood, it's going to rain. and soon it came, and then it was too late. My advice to you, if you do not believe in the Most High God, is to find him while you can now. It's like a landlord getting ready to evict a tenant for non-payment of rent. The Most High is only coming back for his people and the people who believe in him, his son, as well as obeying the commandments. Those are the stipulations that who he's coming back for. Anybody else is going to be evicted off the planet. So my advice to you is to quit laughing at the book of the Bible. It is a history book. And get on the Most High side. Quit getting yourself pinned down in philosophy, vain repetitions of everything that this world has to offer, promoting itself. And we're fixing to see what is getting ready to happen to the people who thought they were the greatest, but now are getting ready to come down. These people went against God's chosen, and now they are getting, without repentance, now they're getting ready to pay the price, and it is a high price they are fixing to pay. For those of you all who are non-black or non-people of color, your blessing is to bless those people, the people who are righteous, in righteous. I'm not talking about people who are robbing, who are black, and this and that, and such like that. We're going to deal with them ourselves. But for those of you all who know these people are very, very spiritual, and you happen to be white, or you happen to be Asian, it would behoove you to honor those people, because these are the chosen people of God. They were smitten upon, they were enslaved, but now they are waking up and knowing who they are. Our people have never come against any other race of people on this planet. So we have a lot of forgiveness because we're the only people that know how to forgive like that. So my advice to you is to research what you have been studying and research what I have presented to you in these three lessons and find out who the children of Israel are, because we presented you evidence like if we were in a court of law. We've got evidence, historical evidence, biblical evidence, evidence coming out your yin-yang. You can't deny this because we know who we are. The question is, do you know who we are? You call us the enemy of the state. We call us the children of God, the Most High. And now the book of Obadiah. The vision of Obadiah, thus saith the Lord God concerning Edom. We have heard a rumor from the Lord, and an ambassador is sent among the sent among the heathen. Arise ye and let us rise up against her in battle. Verse 2, behold, I have made thee small among the heathen. Thou art greatly despised. The pride of thy heart had deceived thee, thou that dwellest in the cliff of the rocks, whose habitation is high, that set in his heart, that saith in his heart, who shall bring me down to the ground? Verse 4, though thou exalt thyself as the eagle, what nations on this planet represents the eagle? You guessed it. You got it. The eagle, and though thou set the nest among the stars, this will I bring thee down, saith the Lord. If thieves came to thee, if robbers by night, how art thou cut off? Would they not have stolen till they had enough? If the grape gatherers came to thee, would they not leave some grapes? How are the things of Esau searched out? I read it again. Verse 6. How are the things of Esau searched out? How are his hidden things sought up? All the men of thy confederacy, verse 7 in Obadiah, the book of Obadiah in your King James Bible. Verse 7, Obadiah. All the men of thy confederacy have brought thee even to the border. The men that were at peace with thee have deceived thee and prevailed against thee. They that eat thy bread have laid a wound under thee. There is none understanding in him. Verse 8, shall I not in that day, said the Lord, even destroy the wise men out of Edom? The wise men out of Edom, and understanding out of the mouth of Esau. Verse 9, and they mighty men, O timid, shall be dismayed to the end that every one of the mount of Esau may be cut off by slaughter. For thy violence against thy brother Jacob, that's why you got to know who you are. If you didn't know you came from Jacob or Israel, then you are lost. You are lost. The Negroes here in America came from Jacob. We are from the tribe of Judah. You all know who I've been talking about. It's on our website right here at Blog Talk Radio, the 12 tribes of Israel, the 12 sons of Jacob. For the violence against thy brother Jacob, shame shall cover thee, and thou shalt be cut off forever. In the day that thou stoodest on the other side, in the day that the strangers carried away captive his forces and foreigners enter into his gates and cast lots upon Jerusalem, even thou waste at one of them. But thou shouldest not have looked on the day of thy brother in the day that he became a stranger, neither shouldest thou have rejoiced over the children of Judah in the day of their destruction. Neither shouldest thou have spoken proudly in the day of distress. Thou shouldest not even entered into the gates of my people in the day their calamity. Yea, thou shouldest not even look on their afflictions in the day of their calamity, nor have laid hands on their substance in the day of their. Could thou have stood in the crossway to cut off those of that day that did escape? Neither should thou have delivered up those of his that did remain in the day of distress. For the day of the Lord is near upon all the heathen. I read it to you again. For the day of the Lord is near upon all the heathen. As thou hast done, it shall be done unto thee. Thy reward shall return upon thy own head. Verse 16, for as ye have drunk upon my holy mountain, so shall all the heathen drink continually. Yea, they shall drink and they shall swallow down, and they shall be as though they had not been. But upon Mount Zion shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possessions. And the house of Jacob shall be a fire, and the house of Joseph a flame, and the house of Esau for stumble, and they shall kindle in them and devour them, and there shall not be any remaining of the house of Esau, for the Lord has spoken it. And they of the south shall possess the mount of Esau, and they of the plain, the Philistines, and they shall possess the fields, Ephraim, and the fields of Samaria, and Benjamin shall possess Gilead. Verse 20, and the captivity of this host of the children of Israel shall possess that of the Canaanites, even unto Zephirath, and the captivity of Jerusalem, which is in Zephirath, shall possess the cities of the south. And saviors shall come up on Mount Zion to judge the mount of Esau, and the kingdom shall be the Most High. Now, that is a prophecy that is getting ready to happen. But first, Israel had to wake up. So, Israel is waking up, and you can see the signs in the earth saying that they are awoke. But the crafty things that Esau want to do is still doing that as we speak. And so this prophecy will come to them unless they repent and show mercy upon Israel. If you bless Israel, you shall be blessed. If you curse Israel, you shall be cursed. So it will behoove you all to know who the righteous people are in the nation of Israel. We're not talking about the land in the so-called Middle East. We're talking about the people who are still in captivity. That's right. We are waking up. Well, this is going to end the enemy of the state, the final episode. I hope you've been blessed by the word. Want to send some final shout-outs to everyone in Southern California, as well as the people that are in the tri-state area, which is New York, New Jersey, as well as Pennsylvania. I always want to thank all our regular listeners in the greater Atlanta, Savannah, and Douglas, Georgia area. Want to send a big shout out to everybody overseas, our international listeners in the UK, as well as new listeners in Australia, as well as everyone that listens on a regular basis in West Africa, Ghana, Angola, as well as Liberia, and in Nigeria. I want to say a big shout out to everyone in Cleveland, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, as well as Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Thank you all for listening to our show on a regular basis. Hopefully you all will continue to listen to us, and we will continue to bring you the very best information as well as great truth music right here on Rhythm and Poetry. Stay tuned for our website by looking in on it at least once a week. Things do change. We are updating it on a weekly basis. Hopefully we will get back to our regular scheduled programs of CSI and Let's Talk, but be for sure that we will always have Rhythm and Poetry unless stated that we're going to be off. But we're here every Saturday at 10 p.m. Central Standard Time right here on the Blog Talk Radio Network at blogtalkradio.com. For myself, Brother Malachi Yasharela, as well as Sister Libra Fire Harris, we will see you next Saturday right here on the Blog Talk Radio Network at blogtalkradio.com. Shalom.
Cause I just wanna live fail. He died for us, so I'ma live fail. Galatians 2:20, I'ma live fail. When y'all some Judas, man, y'all probably snitched though. Not me, cause I just wanna live fail. Go fish and reel them in so I can build fail. Yeah, cause I just wanna live fail. He died for me, so I'ma live for.
Yeah, break the souls into this truth. That's what we here for, that's what we gotta do. James, John, and Peter, yeah, they pillars too. Stretching out my right hand just so I can build with you. Never forget to bless the poor. Give them truth, food, finances. You got extra? Give a little more. I always try to plant them seeds. I'm committed to doing this work, cause the higher gives me all I need. That King James is all I read. So you'll never catch shot in Egyptology. A higher saved us from them Egyptians, they had us captive. Now y'all following one of the nations that had us captive. Now that don't make no sense. Like having unchained pit bulls with no fence. Yeah. Somebody bound to get bit. If you study what you're following, you learn, yeah, it's a lot of lip. Cause I just wanna live for him. He died for us, so I'ma live for him. Galatians 2 and 20, I'ma live for him. Man, y'all some Judas. Man, y'all probably snitched on him. Not me, cause I just wanna live for him. Go fish and reel him in so I can build for him. Yeah, cause I just wanna live for him. Yeah, bringing souls to that righteous too. Sometimes it's more than work, you gotta have that faith too. Faith that Yeshua Christ, that he died for you. Resurrected, now he lives inside of you. I've submitted to that, now I know my role. My spiritual growth is tall like Manute Bowl. If you don't know, your spiritual growth is Muggsy Bogues. Grown kids playing, that's why you're always getting dunked on. Yeah, and I'll be standing there laughing at you. Got all them books, I got that King James stabbing at you. I use them precepts, so I know you feel it. They won't put me on their songs, cause they know I kill it. Yeah, shot of real Judah, yeah, he really drill. Us being the Hebrews, well, that's a big deal. But you know Esau ain't gon' keep it real. Quam Yasha, I love my Hebrews. Yeah, it's time to build. Yeah. Cause I just wanna live for him. He died for us, so I'ma live for him. Galatians 2 and 20, I'ma live for him. Man, y'all some Judas. Man, y'all probably snitched on him. Not me, cause I just wanna live for him. Go fish and reel him in so I can build for him. Yeah. Cause I just wanna live for him. For me, so I'ma live for him. Cause I just wanna live for him. He died for us, so I'ma live for him. Galatians 2 and 20, I'ma live for him. Man, y'all some Judas. Man, y'all probably snitched on him. Not me, cause I just wanna live for him. Go fish and reel him in so I can build for him. Yeah, cause I just wanna live for him. He died for me, so I'ma live for him.
Malachi.